This is Kishmeister on HFM. And my live guest has now arrived.
Yes,
big up,
yes.
Big up Nicewun JM.
Hey, how's everyone doing? And again, you know, big up Kishmeister. Thank you for having us. And HFM too, you know. We've learned this morning that it's definitely a lot quicker skateboarding around London than driving around London, because we've been stuck in traffic, you know. But got her in the end, which is good.
Wicked. It's awesome to have you in London town up at HHQ. And this is round two as well.
Yeah, that's it, you know. We're on radio tour with Kishmeister, my man, you know. So that's what it's about.
So I was hearing Sammy J telling you about arranging an accommodation for yourself in the studio, pot
yeah,
noodles and all of that stuff.
That's it, you know. I had a good camp out here last night, you know. There weren't any wildlife, weren't any bears or nothing. So, yeah, you know, did all right camping here, you know. I didn't want to get you in trouble with the bosses. I didn't really camp here, like, yeah.
All good. So tell us a bit about yourself. Who is Nicewun JM?
So Nicewun JM is me. I'm gonna try and not do like I don't know if you remember back in the day when like Meg Ryan was on like Michael Parkinson's chat show and she was like answering everything. Yes, I've got to remember to do as detailed answers as possible. But yeah, I guess I'm someone who just absolutely loves hip-hop. I love MCing. I definitely pick up inspiration from many different things in life, whether it's, you know, like religious things or films or, you know, or just life experiences and people interaction experiences in general. But yeah, I'm just someone who loves hip-hop and loves being a part of hip-hop culture, you know.
And who are the TSCrew?
Oh, the TSCrew. So that's the Trowbridge Skate Crew. So yeah, basically, like, that wasn't something we invented as well. So like, as young kids, there was already like a TSCrew. So when we started skating, all the older kids were TSCrew, and we were like, oh yeah, we want to be a part of that. And we got older and really into skating. So I'm 34 now, and I started skating when I was 11. So this is going back many, many years. And yeah, TSCrew is just something we've always represented in our skate videos. It's just everything's TSCrew. So, you know, skaters in the town of Trowbridge, really, you know.
Right. So is your boy Danny part of the TSCrew as well?
Yeah, so my twin brother Dan, like, yeah, he's definitely TSCrew, you know. We're both skateboarders, started skating at the same time because we're the same age, you know, and we did everything together because that's what it's like being a twin. But yeah, Dan, yeah, skateboarder, dope skateboarder, and really good boxer as well, you know, so yeah.
Oh yeah, I do see some of those clips on Instagram of you knocking people out and stuff, so
yeah,
it's all good.
He's going red now, he's like going shy and all that, you know.
Well, big up Danny in the studio as well.
Yeah, big up Dan, you know.
I want to ask you, and Danny, if you could tell me as well, is he a good skater?
Oh, for sure, yeah, yeah.
Thank you, Dan, he's got my back. Because I'm best to watch my front, so yeah, yeah. Thanks, Dan.
Give me the 411 on skating, as it were. For someone who doesn't know, like, who are the biggest stars or the brightest talent in the skating scene right now?
That's interesting you said 411, actually, because there used to be a video magazine called 411 Video
Indeed.
Magazine, so yeah, you know, yeah, that relates. But yeah, some of the biggest skateboarders, like, you know, I think everyone knows Tony Hawk, because,
that's
like, you know, I guess... Yeah, vert skateboarder, like, broke records with the 900 in the 90s and whatever. And then everyone's going to know, you know, some of the kind of, like, celebrity pro skateboarders, like someone like a Bam Margera or a Rob Diadec, probably. But, yeah, there's so many different styles and types of skateboarding, and there's just so many legends. Like, I grew up liking people like Mark Appiard and Javier Sarmiento, and then, like, from our country, you know, it would be people like Danny Wainwright and people like that. And also, like, one of my favorite skateboarders who he's one of our good mates, had the pleasure of spending the weekend with him, Coran Gale, you know, amazing world-class pro skateboarder. So shout out to Coran, you know, who I'm sure is probably listening right now, you know.
Well, big up.
Yeah, big up Coran and Rhodey, his wife as well, you know. They both looked after us this weekend for sure.
Thank you for locking in.
Yeah. And their cat Rami also as well. Shout out Rami the cat. He was in my bed last night when I got in, so yeah. And then when I got in bed, he ran out because he didn't want to share it, so yeah.
So, you are from Trowbridge,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's right, yeah. So, county town of Wiltshire, very small town, about an hour away from Bristol is the best way to describe it.
So, would you consider yourself the Fresh Prince of Trowbridge, then?
Ah, you know what? Like, yeah, maybe if I get the jacket, like, Will, if I, like, turn it inside out, then maybe I can be the Fresh Prince of Trowbridge, you know? Like,
And what is it like having grown up in Trowbridge all of this time? Let me know the good, the bad, and the ugly.
Okay, yeah, that's a really interesting one. So the good is, you know, like, some of the people. The bad is some of the people as well. But yeah, you know, I love Trowbridge. It's where I've always lived. You know, it's always been a great town, you know. There is bad and ugliness, like, with everywhere. You know, there's bad situations which, you know, can happen. Like, you know, especially, you know, if... I can think back to when I was younger and there's that town nightlife, you know, and it can get dark at times and whatever. But I think overall, you know, Trowbridge is a lovely place, like, good people. And yeah, I'm proud to be from Trowbridge, you know. So
it's interesting to hear those insights from someone who is a Londoner all of his life.
Yeah, yeah.
They get homesick leaving the M25 and seeing all this weird stuff like countryside and clean air as well. You know, I envy you for having those luxuries compared to a typical Londoner.
Yeah. Well, it's interesting though, because like I really love coming to like the cities, like just like it feels like a little holiday, you know, like visiting Bristol, visiting London, just so much cool stuff's going on around big cities, you know, and I love that, all the graffiti, everything, you know, I just like always got something to look at, which is dope, you know.
And you are not far away from Bristol.
That's
so
right.
Tell us a bit about the hip hop scene and how much access or what you've done sort of like taking part in the scene over there. What is it like down there?
Yeah, so the Bristol hip hop scene's dope, you know, like there's so many like dope people out in the Bristol hip hop scene, and there's like a lot of stuff going on, you know, like for years, like I was going to like the Sip the Juice events, you know, they, you know, Sip the Juice, like they'd hold really big events, bringing big artists down to Bristol, you know, like had the chance to see everyone and anyone over the years, from your Mobb Deeps to MOPs, Wu-Tang, and
all in Bristol.
Yeah, all in Bristol, you know, nice Nas, one. All these, you know, all these like legends you get the opportunity to see. You've got like AFT Raps, which I know Blacksmith does.
That's right.
Yeah, you know, and I've hit up a few of those open mics, which is absolutely dope. Hip Hop Coffee Shop, you know, absolutely dope. But there's, yeah, so many amazing people, and someone who I forgot to shout out yesterday, but I got to because he's just a legend in our area. Doup DJ, Asian Hawk from
The
Disablest, you know, and yeah, Asian Hawk, he's a legend. So big up Asian Hawk, you know. Just a great scene, you know.
And it's definitely something I want to check out in the future. Come down and check out some of that scene. I know Sammy J was saying outside of London, she felt Bristol was really where it's at this point in time.
Yeah, Bristol is like, it's like the graffiti is amazing in Bristol. Like, it's, yeah, just very hip hop, you know. They know how to represent hip hop in its truest form, you know.
Well, let me ask you a bit about hip hop outside of London, I should say.
Yeah,
it has been pretty much dominated around London for like many years. Where do you feel UK hip hop is at now in terms of like breaking through outside of that with all of these different scenes popping off across the UK?
Yeah, you know what's really interesting actually, and I know you and Sammy J, you both had the conversation about it, which was really interesting because you were covering Scotland, you were covering Wales, you know, you're talking about all the different areas, and I think you were also talking about there's some areas which may get like a bit of unfair. Like maybe back in the days in the magazines, they were kind of treated a bit more unfairly because of certain accents.
Snobbishness.
And, yeah, that's it, you know. But I think it's great, you know. It shows, you know, a diversity and a uniqueness of like, you know, all the different, you know, what people go through in their areas. You know, like someone who lives in a beach area, you know, they may have a different story to tell from. you know, someone in the city. So it's just absolutely amazing. And definitely in the Southwest, I know you were playing Leaf Dog and BVA earlier.
That's right.
Like, you know, I remember like getting their Free Amigo CDs back in the day, and like all that stuff was ill, and that was before like the 4 Owls and stuff like that even. So they've been two people have just been killing it for years and years, you know. Doup, top tier lyricists, I say, you know.
Wicked. Well, let's get into a tune or two, and we'll get into more chat in a moment. And also for listeners, we got the Kish Clash coming up later on, yeah, as well.
Looking forward to that.
So this is Kishmeister on HFM interviewing Nicewun JM, yep, on Beats Theory, Llama Direct this Sunday afternoon. And check us out, video streaming on Mixcloud Live and Twitch at HFM.
Yeah, big up Kish, big up Itch.
What's the price of love? Someone tell me what's the price of trust?
Kishmeister of Beats Theory with my special guest Nicewun JM.
Yo yo.
So the choice I just played was Blacksmith and Skinny Man. Big up to Blacksmith and Skinny Man, who came on as special guests on the Jazz Cafe gig on Tuesday just gone. The Large Professor and Static Selector. I almost forgot. Large Professor and Static Selector.
That's Doup.
And
big up Skinny.
Big up Skinny Man. Yep. And also, there was a rap exchange on the support billing as well that got a lot of love too.
Is the rap exchange, is that Mr. Spice from the Brotherhood?
Well, I don't know if he's exactly part of it, but yeah, he's always hanging out with those dudes. And he's always performing with those
guys. Okay, that's interesting. Yeah, I wondered if, because I noticed like Mr. Spice and I kept on seeing rap exchange. So I was thinking, I wonder if that's his new crew or something, you know.
He's definitely everywhere they are.
Yeah,
definitely.
Yeah. Doup.
And also, big love to those that I saw at the Large Professor and Static Selector gig. Static Selector, they both smashed it. Large Professor was only like about 30 minutes long though. So, it wasn't, you know, he could have done more. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah.
And what else was I going to say? Big love to Pedro, who turned up. DJ Trix, Drez, Phil, and DJ Server Love was there as well.
Nice.
And also, when a big up something else that I went to on Thursday evening, it was to see DJ Brother Sanjeev down at Jumbie in Peckham. That was an awesome spot where there was a little bar in Peckham, which is very old school. He had a mixer that was like out of the 1950s, only one deck, so you couldn't mix up and stuff. Lots of vinyl crates all over the spot, and that was really nice. A great setting, him playing tribute to De La Soul amongst other sort of like joints as well. And big love to those that I met down there too, including Michael and Joseph as well.
Big up Michael and Joseph.
So this is Beats Theory with Nicewun JM. So tell us a bit about how you're finding the big smoke of London town.
You know what, I've visited like London so many times over the years, not regularly or anything like that, but you know, we've kind of always come to do things like skating, or I can think of some really good gigs I've been to, you know, down this way as well. But yeah, London's quality, I love the place, you know, so Doup. And just really cool stuff everywhere, you know. Like I feel like we noticed there were a lot of trampolines yesterday. We kept on going places and be like, oh, a trampoline. So I don't know if people hop from one part of London to another part of London on the trampolines. Maybe that's the way of travel because of the traffic, I don't know.
So what have you been up to in London over the last couple of days? What gigs have you gone to or will you be going to?
We've managed to fit in a lot, actually. We did a lot of skateboarding yesterday, so me and my brother Turkey, Karan Gale, our mate, and also as well met two new people, Darius and Kata. You know, both really cool, it was just good vibes skating, like, you know, really trying hard to get the tricks. I wasn't successful with any, unfortunately, but gave them a good go. And then after that we go to DJ Sammy J's show at Itch FM last night. Amazing, had a quality time. And then this morning we've been doing a lot of working out. It looked like sort of like a 90s GMTV exercise video in that living room this morning.
What, Mr. Motivator?
Yeah, it's pretty much like Mr. Motivator. We're all doing the same rhythm of like movement in a, yeah, it was very choreographed. You know what I'm trying to say. But yeah, and then we did some boxing too, you know, that was fun on the pads. And yeah, we're now here at Itch FM with Kishmeister. Amazing quality being here. And then after this, we're going to the DJ 279 event, Flavour of the Month, at the O2 Islington. You know, there's many legends there today. You've got the likes of Rodney P from the London Posse. You've got Blade. You've got MCM from Caveman as well, you know. And yeah, really looking forward to seeing MCM live because I haven't seen it before. So yeah, that's going to be dope.
Awesome. So let's get back into the music and more chat in a bit. Nice to have Nicewun JM on Beats Theory this Sunday afternoon.
Yeah, thank you for having me, you know. This goes out to you. Pull out my wallet, hit the pool and get bollocks. I came to score in pussy galore before I saw it, dropped my jaw, damn. Seen her walk through the door, straight to the dance floor. Whatever fellas want war, but I ignore. Got my eyes on me and more. As I approach, I'm quick to bust and move on the spot. We start chatting a lot and whatnot. Show me what you got. Little lady, DJ drops Jay-Z. Hold her tight, it doesn't faze me. Then my drink, she starts sipping like Amarie. Is this one thing that got me tripping? Just about can't afford another whiskey and coke. I'm broke, making a laugh, got a dig in my jokes. Now we get into a taxi. The night's done, not even contemplating that she could be the one. Ask her what her favourite colour is, she says that she has none. Stay awake and conversate till the morning sun. Don't matter who her favourite rapper is, I'm a goat, not as an MC, as a person, so my lover will devote. Moment I met her, mastermind a plan to get her. Never knew a beauty call would turn to something better. Why do you wanna play a hate on me like the loon is? Friends with benefits like Timberlake and Mila Kunis. Sexy and elegant, she's right in my alley. Never fake in public like when Harry met Sally. No strings attached, got me feeling relaxed. We lay back, maybe I found my perfect match. Not much sleeping going on, 7:59, wake up for work. I gotta go, is that the time? Share stories, loves my attention to detail. A little jealous of men would send a private email. Still I couldn't commit, it is what it is. Really needed a man who was willing to call her his. Now it's time to man up, walking away's a mistake. Don't let fear get in the way of being with your soulmate. Ask her what her favourite colour is, she says that she has none. Stay awake and conversate till the morning sun. Don't matter who her favourite rapper is, I'm a goat, not as an MC, as a person, so my lover will devote. A good mum, and I see her face in our daughters. Deserves the best, this song I have brought her. Smiles, she smiles with her eyes like Tyra Banks. Never thought I'd find perfection, but that the Lord I thank us. I can tell you how I feel about you night and day. And I'll be sure. I love it when you get close to me like you're the cure. Cuddling up in the bed we share when I catch her off guard. Admit the many times I've stared. I fear a tear wouldn't really impress this little dear. Boy, the words suddenly appear every time you are near. So sincere, fear was my job to protect. Barricade the most beautiful girl in the world. Some prince the serenader. So fellas, if you found the love of your life, don't ever let her go. Make that woman your wife. Ask her what her favourite colour is, she says that she has none. Stay awake and conversate till the morning sun. Don't matter who her favourite rapper is, I'm a goat, not as an MC, as a person, so my lover will devote.
She's a queen to me.
Got me fired up.
I got lots of love. She's a queen to me.
Kishmeister on Beat Theory with Nicewun JM.
Yes, big up for playing that one, man. Like,
well, tell us, what did I play? Break
that,
it down.
So that was Favourite Colour, which is produced by my homie who's also a TSCrew representative, Marvin, a Doup. He goes by Afraloon now, but yeah, that's my mate Marv, and he made a banging beat. And then you had Jabba Tha Kut on the scratches on the outro. And yeah, that song was for and was about my wife, Addy Murphy. She's probably blushing right now. She's listening.
Awesome.
But, yeah, love my wife, you know. So.
All right, big up to Dubwise. Thank you for locking in. With the video cameras on live, Mixcloud Live or Twitch at HFM. And big up to the freelance scientists for locking in as well. So that was that joint that I played just now was from a project called Celebrating Hip Hop Over Here.
That's right.
Tell us a bit more about that.
Yeah, so Celebrating Hip Hop Over Here was an album I released in 2021. It was
Was that your first album?
Yeah, first album. So I think it was, what I'd say is, like, it probably was something I worked on for a very long time. I'd say I probably had some failed attempts having a go at making it in the past. Like, I think at the time what I didn't understand was I didn't understand about mixing and mastering. So sometimes when I'd hear the track after doing it, I'd think, oh, is this how it's going to sound? Like, you know, like really worrying and being a perfectionist. But I think, you know, the lockdown happening, that kind of made me decide to give it a go again. And yeah, all the pieces fell in the right place, you know, and yeah, managed to get some really cool people on there. There's the Beat Miners, as we know, who are legends. You know, DJ Evil D from Blaq Moon and his brother, Mr. Walt, you know, legends. We got Domingo on there, Blaq Poet, First and How the Third, and yeah, it's just something I'm really proud of, you know, as an album. So, you know, thank you for asking about that.
So big up Sammy J, she's locked in as well. Thank you.
Yeah, big up Sammy, you know.
So I was gonna ask you, what is it about hip-hop that you cherish so much about it?
You know what, like, I'd love to give an answer, like, you know, which really shows what you've just asked me, but it's like, I don't feel like anything I'd ever say could really do it justice, like how much I love it, you know. But I think back to stuff like, I'm sure you've seen this. Have you ever seen the film Brown Sugar before?
I'm afraid I haven't. Is that a Quentin Tarantino?
Oh, no. So Brown Sugar, it's actually, if you looked at it, it's sort of like, you know, like where it's like judging a book by its cover sort of thing.
Okay.
Yeah, you'd look at Brown Sugar and you'd think, okay, so that's a romantic comedy type film. But it's actually a film which has like a lot to do with hip-hop in it. And at the start of the film Brown Sugar, so the character is a journalist. She's asking the question, when did you fall in love with hip-hop? And she's speaking to people like Kool G Rap, Big Daddy Kane, Pete Rock, all the legends in hip-hop, and it's kind of like documentary style at the beginning. And I feel like, you know, that's that same thing with me, you know. It's kind of like, when did you fall in love with hip-hop? And, like, you know, I can think back to being a kid in 1999 with us buying our first, me and my twin brother who's with me, Dan, us buying our first ever Snoop Dogg CD. And then from there you learn about someone else, and then someone else, you know, and like, and then all of a sudden you learn about Gangstar, you know, and like Gangstar Moment of Truth, that's my favorite album of all time, you know. I love that album.
Oh right, so I was gonna ask you about your favorite album. So Moment of Truth is one of your favorites,
right? Absolutely, you know, Moment of Truth, I love that album. Like, just the style of beats are elevating, you know, the rhymes are elevating. That's always Guru and Premier. I believe that's a quote from what they say, you know.
Well, then just as a digression, fun fact here, I met Guru back in, I think it was 2009 and 2010. It was actually, I think it was just 1 year before he sadly passed away.
Yeah,
he was in London town and he went to a club night called Yo-Yo's in Nottingham Arts Club. It was one of those trendy things, and I don't know how I got in. It was by flute. And we were just there, and he just turned up out of the blue, and I didn't recognize him at first. And then I was thinking, who is this dude? And I realized, because I was with someone who told me that, oh, that's Gangstar.
Yeah,
Scooby, so I should say. And so I had to force myself to sort of like say hello to them. And I said, I asked him, well, I didn't realize it was you, dude. And they said, yeah, that's just how I evolved.
Yeah, yeah.
And we had a little chat and we spoke about Moment of Truth. So it's actually the single, the tune, that means a great deal to me. Pure heart.
Absolutely.
The good and the bad stuff about ourselves as individuals. And they really, really much appreciated what I had said about that. We took a snap. And then I remember him sort of like going off into the dance floor and dancing with some chicks to some reggae music as well.
Yeah, nice.
It's so crazy that time. And to think that I had met him just before he passed away, unfortunately. I'll always treasure that moment for life.
That's amazing, you know. And me and my brother have always said about Guru, he's almost like everyone's wise uncle. Just like
that's
all
right.
The words he says are like, they're so relatable, and it's kind of like, it's almost like advice being given to you, you know. And like, I think, you know, those songs on that Gangstar album, like, I definitely treasure that so much. I feel like, you know, you can listen to like a different Gangstar album, this track, but you can think of like a track like Discipline, and he's given you some real jewels in a track like that or any other. So I think that's what makes Gangstar one of the greatest, you know.
So talking about celebrating about hip-hop over there,
I've
got some questions for you.
Okay.
So you know how there's a lot of usual cliches, the usual debates and topics that affect the hip-hop community over the last 20 years or so. So I'm going to ask you these damn questions.
Okay,
all right?
Yeah. Hopefully I give good answers to them, you know. Like, I'll do my best.
No, they're straightforward. But okay. It'll be interesting to hear.
Okay.
I mean, so one of the very big cliches in hip-hop is, who's better, Tupac or Biggie?
Okay, you know what? Have you ever seen, you might have seen this, the recent Drink Champs episode with MC Shan?
Oh, no, I'm afraid I haven't.
Okay, well, MC Shan was getting asked this person or that person, and every answer he was pretty much saying, both of them, both of them. And yeah, this is where I find it so hard to pick, because Biggie and Tupac, it's kind of like, there could be one day I'm listening to more Biggie songs, and there could be another day I'm listening to more Tupac songs. And I tell you what, I've never been good at putting people in a list of, because they're just so, I can't, I'm definitely one of these people who's
terrible.
Too indecisive.
Terrible.
I know, I'm terrible. I'd be drinking shots if Noriega was asking me this, you know. So,
well, I don't think any of these questions you'll be very good at then.
Okay, ask away anyway. There could be someone who I'm like, oh, definitely that person. Like, we'll see.
Jay-Z or Nas?
Again, I like them both too much. Like, I love Jay-Z and I love Nas, you know. Like, I know the popular opinion is to go with Nas. I tend to see a lot of the time, like, what I notice is, if you're like the real kind of like really underground to the core, it's popular probably to diss Jay-Z, but Jay-Z's dope and he's a legend, one of the greatest. Same with Nas, you know.
Are you sure? Because I think it's the other way around. I think it's more popular to support Jay-Z over Nas, you know.
That's interesting. I tell you what is an easier question for me to answer, like, what did I think was the better diss track out of Ether and Takeover? I personally thought Takeover was the better one. Like, and I know people say Nas took the win with Ether, you know, but you know, that's what I think. But both were dope, and both are legends, you know. I find it so hard to, you know, you definitely couldn't have me in making a straight down the line decision for the world, obviously, because I'd be like, I like this and I like that.
The golden era of hip-hop, 80s, 90s or noughties?
Okay, this I can answer. You know what, I'm gonna go with 90s, and then, you know what, I'd probably go with the early 2000s. I love the 80s stuff as well, but to me, like, it's all about the 90s, and I loved a lot of, there was, you know, a lot of banging, like, Dipset and stuff like that in the early 2000s, you know, so.
East Coast or West Coast?
Okay, I can answer this one. I love the West Coast, but I'd probably have to go with the East Coast, you know, like, that's the Mecca where it started. I'd probably say, you know, there's, like, a lot of, I like both a lot, you know, but I think the East Coast probably dominates my taste more, you know, so.
Favourite Wu-Tang rapper?
Okay, I can answer that. Ghostface Killer.
Well, yeah, I see. Definitely. Interesting.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah.
And
I'm a big Ghostface fan. Right. He's one of my favourite rappers, for sure.
And everyone gets asked this. This is always heated debate.
Okay.
Greatest rapper of all time? Okay. The goat. The goat.
Okay. Like,
you can give a few if you want.
Yeah. Okay. I'll try. You know what? To be honest, I probably say the same as a lot of people do. And because, you know, there's the people who innovated it and so on. But I think to me, I tend to go off who I've seen live as well. And I think KRS-One, like, hands down, like, you know, he just, live performance, he kills it, you know. And yeah, I think KRS definitely up there, you know. But that, like, yeah, you know, Nas and Jay-Z, they belong in that conversation. Obviously, Rakim, Cool G Rap, Big Daddy Kane, Eminem, so on. I'm a massive Snoop Dogg fan, you know, I love Snoop's flow. You know, so I think there's so many different things you can take out of the greatest, but that's obviously American. If we're talking UK as well, you know, you've got to put Kalashnikov, Skinny Man, you know, people like that in the conversation too, you know. So a lot of dope MCs.
Dope, dope. Let's get back into music. More chat in a bit.
Yes, yes.
Kishmeister with Nicewun JM on HFM. And don't forget video cameras on live, Mixcloud Live or Twitch at HFM.
Yeah.
So Nicewun JM, who did I just play?
Hey, yeah, that was Blaq Poet, Ain't Nothing Changed. You know, that's the homie up in New York. Big up Screwball, big up Comet, big up Eric Marsberg. They got the Screwball Radio every Saturday night, you know. But yeah, that's like my favourite Blaq Poet track for sure. DJ Premier, you can't go wrong. The Blaq Print, such a dope album, you know.
So why do you think I'll play the Blaq Poet track?
Yeah, Blaq Poet, one of my favourite rappers, definitely. And yeah, got him on the album too, Celebrating Hip Hop over here. And yeah, Blaq Poet's a legend and just showed me a lot of support, bigging me up on his radio show too. So, you know, big up Blaq Poet.
What's the track called?
The track I did with him. So the track I did with him is called Close to the Edge. Features Blaq Poet and my mate MDV from Trowbridge. Produced by my mate Marvin and Doup from the TSCrew. We got DJ Marlondon on the cuts. And yeah, you know, just a dope track, you know. I noticed as well you played Don't Want to Battle as well. Another one of my tracks. That's produced by Marvin and Doup too. Like, he helped me so much with the Celebrating Hip Hop Over Here album. He's an amazing musician. He can play every instrument. He's just one of those people, and he just had great advice for me, you know.
So I don't want to battle. Does that mean that you'll we'll never see you at Jump Off or Don't Flop?
Yeah, it's not for me. Like mad respect to the people who are really good battle rappers and stuff like that, but I'm not really a competition guy. And I think that song actually came from, I guess, like when I started out rapping, sometimes I go to like a pub or something, and like if people cottoned on to that I was into rapping, they'd be like, oh, come on then, let's battle. And like sometimes it would be like, you know, people who weren't even really into rap, but they just say like whatever at you, you know. And I think it was inspired by that sort of thing, really, you know. But I've got mad respect for people into the battling and stuff, but it's just not my thing and not for me, you know. And I think that's important when things aren't for you, you know, stick to what you like and what you do. Yeah.
So let's get into that Blaq Poet track, Close to the Edge.
Oh, for sure. Big up. Push me, cause I'm close to the edge. Black poet, better know the ledge. Screwball, TS crew, how we do? Can I get a? Can I get a?
Let's go. I know you heard of my destruction all across the world. Got them wilding out, every B-boy, B-girl, yo. Live from the underground, the 4 pound sound like Godzilla just came to town. All you clowns, good night, it's over for y'all niggas. I burn you in your skinny jeans, nigga, I'm a warrior. True microphone fiend, I run amok, leave you stuck on a battlefield. Pure target practice, my mind state data ill. Born in the concrete jungle, where niggas don't give a fuck. Taking whatever come through, you in trouble. I'm the motherfucking wildest, I'm the foulest. Mic in my hand, bucking at the crowd, bitch. Blaq Terminator, crush killer hater. All that hardcore street shit, bow down to the creator. I be the hardest of the hardcore. Screwball, bring the war to your motherfucking front door. What?
Shit, warriors worry, you wanna fuck with John. Major mistake, like a bean of curry. Gotta pray when I'm slipping, or I'm flipping. And as the world burns, remember you must learn. No sing-along song, even King Kong ain't got shit on me. Stood underneath him, a lot of style biters sinking teeth in. But deep and true, I see through juvenile rhymes and fake ass death threats like guru. Think mouths like Billy Bass can't rep to this. The technique, don't sweat to this. Jump around, let to this. Like Nate Dogg, you don't wanna step to this. Trust I prep to this. Don't feel bullshit like cleaners in full fight arenas. Through full Blaq Poet, the meanest. If you're King of New York, you're walking like Christopher C from the UK. Just taking the piss for your street level. So notice like playing the rocker. Still shouting like Puff JM, motherfucker.
So big up to Ali.
Yeah.
Big up to Daniel Murphy. I think that's you. Yeah. So big up. And big up to Dovewise as well.
Yeah.
Again, big up to Sammy J for locking in.
Yeah, and if it's okay, I've got some quick shout outs. Got a shout out Mimski from Germany. You know, she's sent me a beat a couple of months back, which is
awesome,
absolutely
awesome.
Dope. So, and I know Mimski's been killing it with a lot of UK hip hop people. So, yeah, you know, looking forward to that one. Big up Mimski, just talented on any instrument, great producer, you know. I got big up Simon Richmond as well, who's been tuning in. Kathy and Linda Guy, that's my homies too, tuning in. And yeah, Matt Main as well. So, you know, I'm sure there's more people to big up, but yeah, all of you are great and love you all, you know.
Nice one. So we're going to get into Kish Clash shortly, but one thing I wanted to ask you, you post on your Instagram a lot of your CD collection.
Yeah, yeah.
So from albums from the last 5, 10, 15, 20 years, or even 25 years.
Some albums older than me even, you know. I'm 34 and there's definitely some albums I own older than me. And me and my brother's been collecting CDs since we were 11. You know, they all live at mine nowadays because, you know, we're adults and I'm married with children, you know, we don't live together or nothing. And we decided that all the CDs would live at mine because he's a bit more tidy than me. I'm a bit of a hoarder, so that's just the way it worked out. But I'm kind of glad it did because it means I can share, like, and celebrate CD releases, like, for the CDs I own. And it's just a great way to, you know, show that collection to people, you know, and just, like, great musical memories for me growing up listening to that stuff, you know.
So I resonate a lot with that. Yeah. So I used to buy a lot of CDs. It was my product of choice in terms of music. Yeah. And I still invested in CDs a lot. All the way up until I'd say around about 2020, when the lockdown hit.
Yeah.
And I'd say, like, actually it's so much more difficult. Artists don't really release CDs anymore.
Yeah.
So I kind of given up now. And even with MP3s, I feel like that's becoming a bit of a dying product because it's more about streaming these days.
Yeah.
You had posts, so I'm going to actually go through the list.
Okay.
Oh, drop my phone. Hold on one moment.
I wonder if this is going to be a quiz, like, to see if I can know the dates.
Oh, no, not like that.
Good, good. Because I won't, Rodley.
But I wanted to go through, because you posted so many CDs in tribute to your CD collection.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's just go through the last five albums that you had posted up on Instagram.
Okay, cool. Let's do it. All right? That sounds good to me.
The first one is Ghostface Killah and Bad Bad Not Good.
Yeah,
Sour Soul, celebrating its 8-year anniversary.
Yeah, that one was a good one, you know. That was one actually Dan bought. Do you remember buying that one? Or nah, he's shaking his head. Nah, you know. But to be honest, I think I've got most of Ghostface Killah's solo albums. And I know that one's a collaboration album because it's with Bad Bad Not Good. I think there's one or two Ghostface ones I don't own, but I feel like Ghostface has always been consistent with his discography and albums, you know, so you can never go wrong with a Ghostface album, you know.
So that album, so I actually saw Bad Bad Not Good over 10 years ago at the Jas Peterson Worldwide Awards show.
Oh, wow.
So yeah, like, it's a perfect combination, isn't it? Like, such an imitable style over that soundtrack, which is kind of like all sounds like a soundtrack to Pulp Fiction or Western gangster kind of stuff.
That's it. And it is interesting as well because, like, around that time he was also doing the stuff with Adrian Young as well, wasn't he? So it is Adrian Young, isn't it? I'm sure it's Adrian Young. I'm like, I could be wrong if I'm getting the name wrong, but a producer, Adrian Young, he had the 12 Reasons to Die, something like that, wasn't it? Yeah, part one and two. And at that time, he also brought out the Bad Bad Not Good. And he also brought out the 36 Seasons album, I think, which was produced by, like, another kind of live band. So, like, just really interesting. You know, he's, like, works with really good people. My brother's pointing at me, like, hang on a minute. Nah, it wasn't Apollo Brown. Nah. It was like a band. Yeah.
Grandmaster Flash, The Bridge, celebrating 14 years. Now, I don't know much about this album.
It's good. It's a good one. And the track, I'd say, which is especially good, and I don't quite remember the title of it, but it's basically a posse cut where it's like basically different rappers from different countries. So you've got many different languages on this track. KRS-One is probably the big feature on this track. And it's like, I don't speak Spanish, but live this hip-hop or something. I don't speak Japanese, but live this hip-hop. And then you just, like, get a different dope rapper coming in with, you know, from a different country, and you hear all these different languages on a dope beat, and Grandmaster Flash is cutting it up, KRS-One on there. And I remember that album. I think it had Snoop Dogg, Q-Tip, a few others on it. But, yeah, that was another good album as well, you know.
Eminem, The Real Slim Shady, 24th year anniversary.
The Slim Shady LP, I mean, that's just a classic, isn't it, you know? Like,
I mean, it's actually making me feel old that it's now a different, you know, we're almost on the verge of celebrating 25 years of that album. It's like a totally different era now,
you know. But yeah, you know, that track, and I know, like, I'm going to not swear. Sorry, that album, I'm not going to swear, although Eminem just so many swear words in it, you know. But I know we don't swear on radio like that, you know. But yeah, you know, Just Don't Give a F. That was like a classic. And I know before the Slim Shady LP, there was the Slim Shady EP version where the beat was slightly different. And that's a really dope version of it too, you know. But yeah, Slim Shady LP just had like a load of dope tracks. I mean, Guilty Conscience, like, even
classic.
even though like the lyrical content
in
it's a bit gnarly and the concept's a bit gnarly, but it's very clever, very dope Dr. Dre beat, and just dope album, you know.
Marshall Mathers LP obviously was my favourite one, and I got to see Eminem at the height of Marshall Mathers LP at Reading Festival 2001.
I've never seen Eminem live. I'd like to, though. But I'd say my favourite Eminem album is the Marshall Mathers LP as well, you know. Yeah, and I think slightly followed by The Eminem Show. I think that's another really good, solid album as well, you know.
TLC fan mail also celebrating 24th year anniversary.
Yeah, TLC again, just dope, you know. Like, rest in peace, Lisa Left Eye Lopez, you know. No Scrubs being obviously the big single off that one. And I'm a massive fan as well of the Sporty Thieves, who I think are absolutely dope. And I remember being
getting
young,
their own back.
Yeah, and I remember being younger, you know, No Pigeons coming out. So that was kind of like, I think on MTV back in the day in the late 90s when it was like Richard Blackwood on the the call-in show. I remember there was one time where it was like No Scrubs versus No Pigeons, and you had to vote which one got played. So it was a bit of a battle of the men and women type thing, because I'm sure they like to do that in the 90s.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, I mean, Mans was just a little bit busted or bankrupt, you know. It's not his fault.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
To be called a scrub.
Yeah, you know? that's it, you know. Like, I mean, want to get with me with no money, you know. And it's just like, yeah, poor guy.
Black Moon, Warzone.
Yeah, classic, you know. Like, yeah, Black Moon, so dope, you know. Warzone is a dope album. I forget what the track's called. It's got a really dope beat there. It's like, bom, 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 bom. I'm not doing it justice. That's going to sound like I'm making bom, bom, bom noises. But it's just such a dope, heavy album. Like, I love Black Moon. Seen him live before in Bristol. That was like a dope day. And there's a barbecue before it as well. And yeah, Warzone's just like a really good follow-up to Enter the Stage. Just really banging beats. I know Enter the Stage is all produced by the Beat Miners, and I think by the time Warzone came out, it was different producers involved. But yeah, another classic, you know, can't go wrong with Black Moon.
Okay, so we only got about 40 minutes to go, and I always do I've run out of time.
So good.
Let's get straight into the Kish Clash feature.
Yeah, all right? Let's do it.
So we're all going to be arm sass right back now. Talk to us about the first track that you've picked.
Okay, so the first track was actually the first ever hip-hop track me and my brother ever got into, and I think I spoke a bit about this on Sammy J's show yesterday. But yeah, the moment we realised, and I'm speaking for you, Dan, sorry, but I talk it from my perspective, just so I'm not putting words in your mouth. But yeah, the moment I realised I really like hip-hop, that's what I'm into, is being 11 years old, getting Sky, turning on MTV Bass, and seeing the song Still DRE by Dr. Dre featuring Snoop Dogg. I just thought Snoop Dogg was the coolest looking person I'd ever seen in my life, so first choice.
Yeah, nigga, I'm still fucking with you. Still waters run deep. Still Snoop Dogg and DRE. Nah, nigga, guess who's back? Steve.
So heavy joint
yeah.
Right there.
Yeah, 2001 is one of my favorite albums.
No,
it is,
you know. So a lot of focus on the Chronic when they talk about Dr. Dre now, but this is an underrated classic.
I love the Chronic, but 2001 like means more to me because that was that point when I discovered hip-hop. So yeah, I love 2001, you know, great album.
And just as an aside, one of my favorite tracks of 2001 is Bang Bang.
Great.
And
track.
I'll always remember, and I know the year, I don't know the exact date obviously, but I was walking through Bank Underground station in London town, and I saw a busker perform Bang Bang by Dr. Dre.
I just thought,
amazing. You know?
Such a tune. I loved that track, you know. Just amazing album, you know.
So, my track in response... You know what? I don't really play much West Coast. I should do a fair bit more.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know?
I got a lot of love for West Coast music as well. And down south, everything, you know. Down south, everything. I love it.
So, but yeah, West Coast has its own, like, really big legacy in its own right.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm just going to go for the blatantly obvious. One of the legendary of the West Coast scene, the late Tupac.
Ah, classic.
Kishmeister in the middle of the Kish Clash right now with Nicewun JM.
Yes, yes.
So a big up to Savage Slam Radio and Tony Rosie. Thank you for locking in. Thank you to everybody that's watching us live on the video cameras, Mixcloud Live or Twitch at HFM.
Big up.
So, I've actually played, mix it into this track, the Tribe Called Quest, Lyrics to Go.
Yeah, Lyrics to Go.
Because you know what? It's like... I didn't realise until recently the same sample from the Tupac track, Me Against the World, Mini Ripperton.
You know
same
what?
Chords.
Yeah, you know what? I hadn't clicked. It was like the same
two sample. Different interpretations
yeah, yeah,
of that
that's
sample.
That's it, you know, like, yeah, it's amazing, like, how people flip the sample so
that's
differently, you know, like, I love that about hip-hop, you know.
So, let's get into the second track, Take It Away.
Yeah, so the second track I've chosen for the Kish Clash, and the reason I've chose it is because growing up, discovering hip-hop, something I became a massive fan of around the time when I discovered hip-hop was Raucous Records. Like, I was really big into Raucous Records, you know. The Lyricist Lounge Show, you know. Used to love watching that on MTV Bass, you know. People like the likes of, you know, Mos Def, Talib Kweli, you know, Pharoah Monch, you know, tracks like Ol' No being released, the Sound Bombings, the Lyricist Loungers, just like absolutely massive fan of Raucous Records. That's some of my favourite hip-hop ever. And the reason why I've chose the next track is because it's one of my favourite tracks ever. It's also the track I used on my first ever skateboarding video part. So it kind of like means... a lot to me, and I kind of like associate this song with myself a lot. It's called The Life, and it's by Styles P featuring Pharoah Monch. And again, Pharoah Monch, one of my favorite rappers. So yeah, take it away.
My life, Pharoah Monch, Ayatollah, Howie McDuffie, Holiday Styles, Double R, Raucous Records. Barrel, talk to him. Let him try to understand. Let him try. Let him try that.
My life is all I have. My rhymes, my pen, my pad. And I'd have made it through the struggle. Don't judge me. What you say now won't budge me. Cause where I come from, so often. But I'd have made it through the pain and strife. It's my time now.
Big up to Savage Slam Radio, loving your choice, Nicewun.
Yeah, big up MDV, that's my homie from Trowbridge, you know, so big up MDV. Yeah, big up for tuning in, you know.
So another wicked choice. So I remember this very well as well, back in the... Yeah, yeah. I think, so I certainly know about this. My memories are in the early noughties when I was at university, when everything was going wrong. Everything. So this is the perfect track for when things are going wrong, basically.
Wow. Okay.
So, and obviously A Gangster and a Gentleman, a classic album as well.
Absolutely.
Very good.
Great Styles P album, you know.
So, my track in response, well, so you spoke about Pharaoh Monch on this. Isn't it funny how Pharaoh Monch is kind of like that really soft, soulful, sort of like dude on the chorus hook? And yet he's a dude that's also done Agent Orange and one of the biggest club bangers in hip hop ever, Simon Says,
right? For sure.
Is that two completely different extremes?
Well, you know, Pharaoh Monch, one of my favourite MCs ever. I love Internal Affairs, I love the album Desire, I love the album War, you know, like and I know Organised Confusion as well, you know, just so many classics. And I think one of my favourite intros ever to an album where it's just like an MC like spitting for spitting, you know, is the Internal Affairs intro.
Yeah.
I just feel Pharaoh Monch goes off on that Internal Affairs intro, you know, and like just so dope, just amazing MC, and you know, like, yeah, one of my favourites for sure, you know, and singer, you can't knock a singing, so dope, so soulful.
So my track in response is another track where Pharaoh Monch is more on the soulful sort of like singing vibe. He did a track called The Light.
It's The Light. Yeah. One of my favourites.
Most hip-hop heads don't like it, though. They think that's too soft for them. But no, for me, awesome. So that is my joint. That's my joint in response.
Yeah, I love that track.
Twisted around her, she shifted the crown. I was like, oh, she's off the hook. And I know you will see the light, baby. Once you understand what you mean to me, darling.
See the light, baby. Once you understand what you mean, what you do, no doubt.
You enjoying that?
Yeah, it's safe to say that was a dope choice. You know, we got hyped. Me and my brother Dan were like rapping all the lyrics along to it, and amazing choice. Such a classic. I love, and anyone who's like that soulful or too soulful or too soft or whatever,
too soft for a hip hop dude that Ray Simon says,
then then they're like, you know, they don't understand.
They don't have a clue.
Yeah, they don't have a clue. That's dope. That's real. That's, you know, real emotion for sure.
So let's get into the third track. You probably have one both rounds, to be fair.
Yeah, yeah.
So
I'd say you know what?
Well, thank you, Danny.
I'm gonna do the whole back to the Tupac and Biggie debate, you know, like both are really good. So yeah, you know, I can't choose a winner. That will let the audience decide, the listeners, they can choose the winners, because I can't. All the tracks have been dope and solid, you know. Yeah.
All right, let's get into the third track.
Yeah, so the reason for my third choice actually, like, is I feel like a moment where like it was like really getting into UK hip-hop, and I definitely heard quite a bit of UK hip-hop before this. You know, there was obviously the classics which were out, like stuff like, you know, which were big, stuff like Roots Maneuver, Witness the Fitness, and you can think of things like Blaq Twang, So Rotten, and you know, all these amazing tracks, you know, which probably were a bit higher on the radar when it came to UK hip-hop. But I remember The reason why I've chose this track is because, I guess, the emergence of Channel U, really. And, you know, at the time on Channel U, there, you know, just a variety of different music genres and so on, you know, a lot of grime and whatever else. But I remember it was actually Dan, I think you saw this first, so my brother Dan, who's with me, obviously, you all know that by now. But Dan was going, yeah, this dude Kalashnikov, like, yeah, so dope, he's amazing. And it was the track All I Got, and Dan was saying, yeah, I saw this music video, Kalashnikov, like really dope UK hip-hop, you know. And I think I was then looking out for it on Channel U, and then I saw it, and we were like, Yeah, All I Got by Kalashnikov. That's a banger. We loved that. And that was the first ever Kalashnikov song I'd ever heard. And then from that, you know, all of a sudden you're discovering Murder and whatever else. And, you know, from the great album, The Sagas of Kalashnikov, like absolute classic. And, you know, it was between two songs, actually. It was either going to be All I Got by Kalashnikov, or I was going to go with I'll Be Surprised by Skinny Man. And that was because the first time I ever heard that track was on a skate video, a classic UK skate video called Blueprint Lost and Found. But I think we heard All I Got first, a little bit before I'll Be Surprised by Skinny Man. So that's what I've gone with, All I Got by Kalashnikov this time. But yeah, it's a banger. Enjoy.
Let's get into it.
Yeah, what? Oh yeah, yeah, it's the Joe Buddha, yeah. Kalashnikov. What?
Rocky Road.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, 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 yeah.
A bitter like surrogacy when you told in custody. TDA, GBH, there's no escape when you trapped in an estate with a ghetto mind state. Yeah, it's not a joke, mate.
So that is Kalashnikov, All I Got.
Yeah, classic.
Yeah, the album is, it'll go down in history as one of the all-time greats, full stop.
Yeah, one of my favourites, like, literally, like, start to finish. I love that album, you know, like, and, you know, it ends on Son of Naya, which is such a banger as well. I know when I usually see Kalashnikov live, he usually does, like, the Sizzler focus mode version, but I really love the version off the Sagas of Kalashnikov. You know, that beat, I think, is just heavy, you know. So
in response, I was actually going to play another Kalashnikov track from the album as well.
Interesting.
But what I've just done now is changed it just in light of what you said, so that I know I'm going to win this round.
Nice. Okay.
I will play Skinny Man, I'll Be Surprised for
Nice. Oh, I love that track. Classic, you know.
There's gonna be a massacre straight after the sun goes down. Going out for all of them haters and running them down.
So nice one, JM. I would say, like, this has become a bit of a trend. Opponent, picks Kalashnikov and I always pick Skinny Man in response, because that's exactly what happened with the Sammy J song.
You know what though, like, it makes sense, because, like, I know everyone's gonna have their different opinions for favorite albums, but definitely two of my favorite albums ever are The Sags of Kalashnikov and Council Estate of Mind. So those, you know, I've even seen articles where people have said that's the top two, and there's a reason why a lot of people share that opinion, because they're two of the best albums, start to finish, in the sequence into them, everything, you know. So yeah, big up Kalashnikov and big up Skinny Man for just creating two inspirational classic albums, you know,
and helping set the foundations for an amazing scene.
That's it, yeah, without a doubt, you know.
So we just got 10 minutes to go. Thank you very much all for locking in again. Thank you, Dovewise, much love for checking in.
Yeah,
we want to get you just in that 10-minute squeeze in a freestyle from yourself.
Yeah, for sure.
So just before we get that done for the end of the show, just give us your socials and what your next ventures will be.
Yeah, okay. So, I'm the Nicewun JM, you know, representing the TS crew. I've got an album out, I'm probably sure you've heard already, Celebratin' Hip Hop over here. Features Blaq Poet, The Beat Miners, First and How the Third, Domingo, Jabba Tha Kut, Mac Lloyd, Marvin the Doup, DJ Marlondon. Hope there's not anyone I've forgotten. But yeah, you know, just a lot of dope people involved in that one. Also got to big up my homie Obeya Jed, who I haven't bigged up yet, because he did all the recording and again was so helpful, you know, in making that album. So big up him. I've got loads of social medias. Instagram's my favourite one, TSCrewJM. Share all my CDs and skating and what's going on there. Got the Nicewun JM YouTube channel. Yeah, I'm always putting as much content on it as I can. I've got the Facebooks and everything else, you know. And also, if you like skateboarding, check out TSCrew Skateboarding on YouTube. You know, you won't be disappointed.
Nice one. Thank you very much. So we're just going to play one track and we'll set up a beat for the final 5 minutes with you freestyling. Yeah. Thank you.
Big up, Kishmeister. Big up.
Still under the cosh, the cops brandishing. You could be going to work.
So just going to cut this short. This is Michael Parkinson, as Nicewun JM predicted.
Yeah.
But I'm going to get into the next beat now. Thank you very much for blessing us with a freestyle, a few bars.
Big, you know.
Let's get into straight into the beat.
Yeah, big up Michael Parkinson. Oh, yeah, shit. Big up Blaq Poet. Screwball. Hoo-han. Say it loud. I'm hip-hop and I'm proud. Showing and proving, giving a mic and I'm moving the crowd. My rendition got me singing 1, 2, 3. Give it up for John Murphy. The definition of a hip-hop head insisting. Use intuition on the composition. Transition wouldn't listen. Your vision of bars just spitting. The juice you ain't sipping ain't spoon-fed. Bars over your head. The most slept on. The one that stands in a single bed. And the bed's bending. The joke's on the rapper like a purple pick up a penguin. Nobody move, nobody get hurt. Ain't sweet, go eat some dessert. Throw at them peace signs, don't do drugs. But I've got the dope lines. Rappers think they're Big Ben, acting big time. Check it out, 1, 2, and I'm still getting mine. Need a hobby to kill time, smash at clocks with a hammer. Get your salty shots, like tequila slammers. Oh, you want more? Like Ty, involve all my options. The limit is the sky. Going around the helter scout like Rock and Rock, Sean Price. Not stuck in a rut, learn from diverse advice. Bar something concise, try to keep it precise. How far I move ahead, got me rolling the dice. The nice one, the alias, not kept down by the craziness. Coronavirus world, surreal but not facing. As the bite is worse than the bark. Keeping it tight, like badly designed car parks. Too quick for the eye, like a Tom Penny back tail shirt. Radio Raheem, hate versus love. Get up, get on up like James Brown. One thing's for sure, you can never keep me down. Check it out, 1, 2, how we do? Nicewun JM, got a bigger Kishmeister in the place to be. It's FM, 1, 2, how we do? Check it out, 1, 2,
Yo,
involve
thank you very
crowd,
much.
Give all the energy I've got while boring MCs. Studying legends from the golden age. If they ask for any local MCs, then I'm jumping on stage. Like when I raps live with J. Rude, I'm just out of X. Then I kill the MC, coming live and direct. If my words are a puzzle, start the countdown in a bit. Din it, din it, din it, din it. Train to be better, box bees like Killer Keller or Killer Acapella. Steez like a good fella, 2 times good fella. Dodge a hater, Chuck and Stella. They need no umbrella, Ella, 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 Ella. In the jam like Paul Weller. Well, I'm Mike and me, the perfect match like Cellar Dwellers. Making a crowd move, making them use the cerebellum. Still keeping away from devils because my soul will never sell them. Tell them. Yeah,
wicked.
Big up Kishmeister.
Wicked. Thank you very much, Nicewun JM.
Yeah, big up, man. Such a pleasure. Enjoyable, man.
So that's the end of the show for today. Thank you very much for everybody locking in. Much appreciated. I'll be back next week with another interview as well. But Nicewun JM and Danny, much love for coming down to London Town, gracing their presence in HFM.
Big up, bro. It's been enjoyable, man.
Have a good day and have a good time at Flavor of the Month as well. Tony Rosie is here. I can't believe it. Tony
Rosie. How's it going? Nice to meet you, man. Big up, Tony Rosie. Make sure you stay tuned in to him next.
Absolutely. Tony Rosie up at 2 o'clock. Much love. Nicewun JM, thank you again.
Thank you. Have God bless you all, you know. Peace.
As you call them, they call you when they need some trees for the blunt to G's for the front.